नमस्ते, दिस इज डॉक्टर उपमा राजेंद्रन फ्रॉम डिवाइन वेदा. डिवाइन वेदा एज ए टीम इज ऑन फॉर अ मिशन टू मेक आयुर्वेदा हर्ड थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड.
वी नीड योर सपोर्ट फॉर दिस. एज अ टोकन ऑफ ग्रेटिट्यूड, डिवाइन वेदा इज गिविंग गिफ्ट वाउचर्स वर्थ ₹500 फॉर एन एक्टिव सब्सक्राइबर एवरी वीक. एंड दिस वीक्स एक्टिव सब्सक्राइबर नेम विल बी अनाउंस्ड इन दिस वीडियो. Please watch this video till the end to know who is that active subscriber.
Ayurveda had stressed the value of safe motherhood. After delivery, the mother needs to be looked after with greater care and vigilance. During pregnancy, the fetus attains its nourishment from the mother's body. This makes the seven dhatus of the mother weakened and diminished from the usual state. After delivery, the mother's health becomes weak due to loss of fluid and other dhatus from the body, as well as the emptiness created in the body after the expulsion of the fetus from the uterus. This phase is called as Sutika period, a term derived from the word prasuta, which means a mother after delivery. A special regime for the mother after delivery is recommended for this period to make her compensate the loss of fluids and other dhatus during the pregnancy and delivery.
Ayurveda says that after delivery, the mother's Agni will be low and Vata dosha is vitiated immediately after delivery. The basic aim of postnatal care is Agni Deepanam, Yoni Shodhanam, Vata Shamana, Stanya Janana. Agni Deepana means the digestive fire has to be improved. In Yoni Shodhana, that is, the uterus has to be cleansed. And in Vata Shamana or in Vata Analomana, initiated Vadas has to be brought back to the normal. And Stanya Janana, Ayurveda gives importance to the baby as well as the mother.
The postnatal care has three stages, which can be categorized based on the medications used. In the first week, the postnatal care or the Sutika Paricharya is mainly for the uterus cleansing, that is Yoni Shodhana plus the Deepana Pajana. The initial week soon after delivery is of immense importance, both for the mother as well as for the newborn child. The process of child delivery is caused by the Vata activity. The Vata will be immensely increased soon after the delivery. The digestion of the mother, the immunity of the mother will also be at very low. Hence, special care to balance the Vata and to strengthen the mother is very important. The postnatal care in the first week after the delivery, these following procedures and the diet has to be followed.
Abhyangam has to be done. Start oil massage after 5 days or after 10 days of delivery. Massage with certain Vata Anulomana kind of medicated oils. It helps to strengthen the ligaments, muscles, tendons, joints of the whole body. It soothes the skin as well as from the pain. Then it's followed by the bath. The lady after delivery should take bath in the morning with the water boiled with herbs which are for the balancing of Vata dosha. Then the abdomen should be properly wrapped with big clean cloths, followed by Sneha Panam, that is intake of ghee or oil, which is to be selected based on the custom followed in the women's maternal family. The dosage is based on the strength of the Agni, and intake of medicated ghee should be very light immediately after the delivery. The diet has to be very light immediately after the delivery. After ensuring that the administrated ghee is completely digested, a thin gruel prepared with rice or barley, adding with pepper, can be given to the women. Cooked rice and boiled vegetables can also be given to the women. It is advised to give jaggery water to improve the mother's strength and relieve her from the tiredness. For this, with the jaggery water, you can add trikatu churna in that. And this mixture can be had twice a day.
The first 3 months after delivery is very important for the mother. During this period, the expanded uterus shrinks back to the normalcy. Ligaments and the muscles and the tendons associated with the uterus starts gaining back to the lost power. The mother also recovers back the mental strength, which will be a bit low in the first week of delivery. Mild walking is okay, but rigorous work, heavy weights and the lifting of heavy objects is totally discouraged. It makes the uterine muscles and the tendons weaken. Uterine prolapse during post-midlife is linked to the improper sudhika paricharya of the mother as well as with the rest the mother takes. Some Ayurvedic medicines have to be taken in the initial couple months of delivery to relieve from the pain as well as the inflammation, and it also boosts her the immunity as well as keep most of the infections at the bay, and also to help her to induce the normal lactation. And from 8th day, the Ayurvedic herbs which are sweet in taste, which balances the Vata Dosha and which are Jivaniya in property can also be taken. And cooked rice with meat soup can also be taken at this stage. Have food which are having high fiber content in it. Green leafy vegetables and fruit, particularly pearl onions. Avoid fish, meat in the diet for the 12 days after the delivery. Avoid green chilies, tamarinds, fatty foods, and consume hot water. The other contraindications are anxiety, stress, sexual intercourse, exercises, panchakarma treatments such as virechana, sthapanavasti, etc. Seasons and the places plays an important role in postnatal care of the mother, as these both can affect her mentally and physically. Postnatal care during winter and rainy seasons and as well as in the moist places. Due to the coldness, the Vata and the Kapha Dosha will be in its highest. Because of this, the digestion power will be very low. Hence, in the initial 3 days, the ghee has to be avoided. Instead, we can give her rice with some pinches of ginger and pepper in it. Once after the digestive power is improved, the ghee processed with pepper and ginger can be given. The woman has to wear the clothes which are warm and soothing in nature, and her ears has to be kept closed. The dietics as well as the activities has to be hot in nature. The postnatal care in summer and in these type of conditions, the Pitta and the Vata Dosha will be highest. Hence, the ghee processed with long pepper can be given. The oil massage can be done, followed by a hot water bath. Postpartum depression. Postpartum depression is an increase of Vata Dosha. A depressed mother may become apathetic, emotionally withdrawn, and unresponsive to her offspring. While the first month of newborn's life are most sensitive period for both the mother and child bonding. Postpartum depression is harmful to the development of the newborn. The early socialization, the cognitive development, and the speech acquisition are largely in mother's hand. Here, the women requires samsajana karmas, which are tonification therapy and rasayana. The types of herbs that are to improve the rasas and the other dhatus, and it slowly builds up the digestion. Healthy herbs can certainly be helpful in supporting the health. Ayurveda emphasizes curing the diseases at its root cause, mainly through lifestyle decisions and food intake. This includes the quality of the food, whether it is dosha appropriate, when it is eaten, how slowly it is chewed, and how peacefully the environment is in which it is eaten. The lifestyle decisions such as avoidance of stress, daily abhyanga, tongue scraping, pranayama, meditations are the basic foundation of strong Ayurvedic practice. The more details regarding the diet
and the home remedies for the breastfeeding mother will be given in our upcoming videos. Those videos link you can find in the description box given below. And now it's time to announce who is that active subscriber. The active subscriber is Chidambar K. Congrats, Chidambar. Thanks for your support, and we expect the same in the upcoming videos as well. The lucky winner should get in touch with Divine Veda team by sending an email to contact@divineveda.com.
Till we meet next time with a new video and a new topic, this is me, Dr. Rukma Rajendran, signing off. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.